Now on the case, Phillip de Wet is a South African journalist and associate editor of the Mail and Guardian. He joins us now from Johannesburg. Thank you, Phillip, for being with us. My first question to you, Phillip, what is your take on the prosecution's very aggressive approach and line of questioning with Oscar Pistorius, and how is South Africa reacting to this?
Well, it wasn't unexpected that the prosecution would be quite aggressive in the questioning, but I don't think we anticipated just how aggressive prosecutor Harry Nell would be right from the outset. He showed today that he can flatten Oscar Pistorius by playing on his emotions and his trauma at any time, and I think that must have taken aback the defense team. It certainly did take back a large number of South Africans. There was a fair bit of sympathy for Oscar Pistorius, as there has been throughout this trial. And yet there were also many voices saying there is a dead woman here. She requires a trial, which we can all see was as harsh as may be necessary. So I think there was also a lot of sympathy for the prosecution's approach.
And you being a journalist, I want to get your take on the media coverage in South Africa. Before I do, I want to go through a selection of what South African newspapers are saying about this case. Nell roasts Oscar is the Star's lead, referring to prosecutor Harry Nell's cross-examination. It also features a screen cap of the video showing Pistorius at a shooting range. Afrikaans newspaper, The Bild, also carries a story on its front page. The headline translates as Oscar's raw grief. Now, while The Citizen focuses on the Steenkamp family's grief, going with the headline, Day of Tears. How has the media coverage been, and has it been helping or hurting Oscar Pistorius?
Well, it has been pervasive for one thing. The trial really has South Africans riveted, especially now that Oscar Pistorius himself is speaking. Both in the media and in public perception, though, things can swing quite dramatically from one day to the next. We've been moving through testimony in painstaking fashion. And if you focus on the moment in court, you can make up your mind quite easily. But looking at the totality of the evidence before the court so far, it's impossible for a lay person simply to come to any conclusion based on that. So you will find both strong pro and anti Oscar Pistorius camps. You will find certain people who focus on Reva Steenkamp and on the grief of the Steenkamp family, but that can shift quite dramatically. I would say opinion on this is quite fickle at the moment.
And I want to ask you this, because we know that Reva was also a star in her own right, and her reality show recently hit TV screens, you know, after her death. The timing is interesting. What is your take on that?
Steenkamp during life was very much in the shadow of Oscar Pistorius, as both of them have pointed out while Steenkamp was still alive, and as is quite clear from the testimony from Oscar Pistorius. So while she was a celebrity in her own right, Oscar Pistorius was the Paralympian who became an Olympian. He had overcome a troubled childhood. His story was just so much more compelling. And I think that's playing out in the trial right now. Increasingly, it seems that Oscar Pistorius is the center of the story, that Reva Steenkamp is somewhat of a back character, and I guess a victim in all of this.
And you kind of touched on this, but I want to ask you again before we let you go, Phillip, where is public opinion in South Africa on this case? I know you said it changes from day to day, but where are we now?
I think the only consensus that we really have is that people want to see a fair trial. The greatest outrage and spikes in outrage that we've seen is when it has been perceived that the court process is failing, that the translation isn't adequate, the time isn't being used well. So I think what South Africans want to see is a thorough trial, a fair trial, whatever the verdict may be at the end of the day. At the moment, I think under today's cross-examination and the dramatic cross-examination that we saw, opinion is shifting against Oscar Pistorius perhaps a bit. You will find people who believe that he is overplaying his grief, that he's using emotion, that he's abusing his disability as an excuse. And there's a lot of cynicism among South Africans, but I'm pretty sure that that will change again in the next couple of days and again after that.
Sure thing. Yeah, Phillip de Wet, associate editor of the Mail and Guardian in South Africa. A very interesting perspective. Many thanks to you, Phillip.